Hold on now. You think that orbital mechanics is boring? Huh. You know, I can teach you a thing or two about it, and we can have some fun while doing so.
So, who are you?
Well, I'm Danish astronomer Tycho Brahe.
Well, what have you done to help me, and what have you done? I don't know you.
Well, for one, I debunked Aristotle's unchanging celestial system, described in his book, De Nova Stella. This was important, as previous scientific thought mandated that the universe was unchanging and that any new astronomical phenomenon was below the atmosphere. I debunked this by monitoring the position of a supernova and using parallax.
Okay, so can you like explain to me like I'm five?
Parallax is a phenomenon where objects that are closer appear to move faster than those that are, which are far away. Now over here, I've drawn some trees and a mountain. Let's say you were moving past it. The trees would appear to be rushing past you, while the mountain would appear to not move at all. With parallax, we can understand that the trees are actually closer than the mountain, which is why they appear to be moving faster. Since this object, a supernova, appears to not move at all, we can assume that it is outside of the atmosphere, thus debunking Aristotle's theory.
Wow, that's certainly impressive.
Well, we've barely even begun. Soon after this, King Frederick II of Denmark gave me my own island for an observatory known as Uraniborg. It was there that I observed the stars and wrote down a great deal of data. Instead of looking at stars, let's see, every few months, I observed them every single night and took down the data. I observed that the stars didn't seem to move much at all, meaning that they had little to no parallax. Now, this meant two things. Either one, the stars were really far away, or the Earth was immobile and could not move, thus accounting for the parallax.
So which of these two theories did you go with? Is it actually possible that the stars can be that far?
Of course not. That would be absurd. Nothing could be that far away. Instead, I believe that the Earth is simply not moving at all. This must account for the lack of parallax. With this, I have created a new model, the Tychonic System.
So what's that?
In order to account for the Earth not moving, I have various planets orbiting the Sun. However, since the Earth cannot move, the Sun instead orbits the Earth.
Whoa. Wow, all that science, that's so impressive.
Unfortunately, not all good men meet good ends. After I was exiled, I took on an assistant named Johannes Kepler. We never got along, but he was a very smart man. After my death, he stole all my data and used it for his own benefit.
That's truly tragic. Didn't that, like, Kepler guy kill you?
Despite the rumors, this was actually not true. Centuries after my death, my body was tested, and scientists found that although there was mercury in my body, it was nowhere enough to kill me.
Hey Kepler, I've been studying the stars, and I've realized some of them are going in a weird direction. What's up with that?
Well, funny you asked. I've been tracking the same stars too, and turns out they're not actually stars at all. Those are actually planets.
No way. So how do they all shine like that?
Well, that's because planets reflect the sun's light back at us, just like the moon.
Interesting. But I still can't figure out how the planets are moving the way they are.
Yes. This is where I begin to think outside the box. Or, in this case, a circle. I created three laws of planetary motion. The first law of eclipses. This one is an easy one. It states that all planets in the solar system orbit the sun in an elliptical pattern, with the sun being at the focus.
So the sun can either be here or here?
Yes, indeed. A second law is called the law of areas. Look at this red area. It looks smaller than the blue area, but by my law, it says that regardless of the size, the planets will move across the both areas in the same amount of time.
Oh, that's because of the sun's gravitational pull, right?
Yes, indeed. A third law explains that time equals KR cubed. K equals one Earth year squared divided by the distance between the Earth and the sun squared.
Did your people at the time believe you?
No. Actually, at my time, religion ruled everything. Many religious leaders were against my findings. Not only that, even some of my astronomer friends disagreed with my findings.
So, what did you do despite their criticism?
I just kept doing my research and remained headstrong. And that's what you do in your class. You stick through the boring, tough, annoying parts, so then when you get to the fun parts, like flying rockets, it will become much more enjoyable.
Wow. That is actually really inspiring. Will I ever see you again?
Whenever you look at the planets, or you think where you're going in the universe,
take your memories, I don't need them. Take your space and take your reasons, but you think of me. And take your cap and leave my sweater, cause we have nothing left to weather. In fact, I feel a whole lot better, but you think of me. Someday I'm gonna run across your mind, but don't worry, I'll be fine. I'm gonna be alright while you're sleeping with your pride, wishing I could hold you tight. I'll be over you and on with my life. So take your records, take your freedom.